Hello everyone, welcome back to CAD Tools for Beginners. In this tutorial, we will start drafting environment in CATIA V5. So, as you can see, we have already seen this example in the earlier tutorial. So, let's start with the drafting. So, there are two ways you can go into the drafting environment in CATIA V5. So, first we will discuss is go to the start, go to the mechanical design and go to the drafting. So once you click on the drafting, you will get this pop-up new drawing creation, and here we need to provide select an automatic layout. So we need to provide an input, so you can keep this as empty sheet, or you can get all the views, front, bottom and right views, and top, front top and left view. So again here, if you want to change the sheet, then you can go to the modify and you can change the standard and you can again change the paper size or the sheet size depending upon your requirement. So in here below you can provide the portrait or the landscape orientation. So we'll keep this as landscape orientation and just click on OK. So now we will go with the empty sheet and just click on OK. So you can see the drawing environment here. So now again I will just close this, and now one more way is to go with the file and new, and here you need to select the drawing and just click on OK, and again the similar pop-up arrives here to select the standard, select the sheet size and the landscape, but with this option you can only get the empty sheet, you cannot get the default views which we have an option with the start and mechanical design and drafting option. So now we are in the drafting environment in CATIA V5. So we will first discuss about the drafting. So basically why we use drawings. So basically the drafting is used for providing the dimensions and tolerances. So it is nothing but a manufacturing drawing. So the drawing which need to be submitted for the manufacturing purpose. So it includes all the dimensions, all the tolerances, all the GD&T dimensioning inside it, as well as all the notes, materials, whatever the details we need to provide for the manufacturing are all mentioned in the drawing. So again it is used to create the standard views, the different views such as front view, top view, section views, different views we can create in the drafting to provide the different symbols like GD&T, surface finish symbol, roughness, welding symbols, etc. We can use drafting. The next point is it is used to add the bill of material for the assembly drawing. So if we are working for the assembly drawing, we can provide the list of all the parts related to weight, all the details we can provide including in the bill of material. So next we will discuss about the types of drafting. So there are two types of drafting. First is the generative type, so which is bidirectional. So that means if you change the part, if you make changes in the part, it will automatically reflect in the assembly as well as in the drafting. So that's why it is the generative drafting have bidirectional associativity, and generating the views with respect to the 3D model which is created in the any of the environment such as part design environment, surfacing environment. The next type is the second type, that is the interactive drafting. So it is used to create the profiles views like we did in the AutoCAD. So in the manual manner. So if you see in the drafting environment, you can see there are different options available such as line, point and circle which is used for the interactive type of drafting. So now let's discuss about the initial settings required in drafting. So first one is we need to set the projection method. So whether we want to keep it first angle projection or the third angle projection. So to set the angle of projection, we need to double click on the sheet. Once we double click on the sheet 1 in the specification tree, the sheet gets activated, and you can just right click on it, go to the properties, and here in the properties tab you can see the option available here, that is the projection method. So the first angle standard or the third angle standard. So by default in CATIA the first angle standard is selected. If you want to change it, you can change it just by clicking the bubble over here. So I will keep this first angle standard as it is, and here again you can provide the name. So you can provide the name to the drawing. So let's type as first drawing. You can set the scale, you can set the scales like 1 by 2 1 by 4. So you can provide a scale depending upon your requirement. The format you can provide, you can select the sheet size here as well, you can change the size. Then again the orientation, portrait or the landscape, which we have already selected while creating the new sheet. So these are the different options available over here in the properties menu. So I will just select this first angle and click on OK. So as you can see, the name is changed for the sheet. So now we'll see about the frame and the title block setting. So to set the title block, we need to first go to the edit. We need to go to the sheet background, and you can see we are in the sheet background now, and on the right side there is an option available, that is frame and the title block. So it's just nothing but a addition of title block in the drawing. So just click on it, and here the manage frame and title block definition dialog box is opens, and here we need to select the style of the block, whichever is available here. So I will select the sample 2, and in the action we need to select the create option. So again here you can delete, resize, update, check by, so whatever the options are available you can select. So I will just create it. So first click on OK, and now you can see the title block is added over here in the sheet. So again we need to go to the normal in the working views. So again go to the edit and click on working views. So now you can see the sheet, and here is the title block. So we'll see the title block here. So depending upon the style we have selected, the title block is getting added, and here you can see the default system, which is the name of the project, you can say here the drawing title, the size, whichever is the size available, that is A0, drawing number you can mention, revision, weight, scale 1:1, then the drawn by, date, checked by date, designed by date. So these are the information which can be stored in the title block. So if you want to edit this title block, again you need to go to the edit and go to the sheet background, and here you can just double click on the any of the title, and you can see there is a text editor opens up. You can change the name, and again you can change the drawing numbers and scale, whatever you want to change. So in this way we can add the title block. So again go to the edit and working views. So in working view you cannot change the title block, so you cannot double click on it and it will not be edited. So now we'll see the next setting. Let's consider if you want to change the drawing size. So again you can double click on it, go to the properties of the drawing or of the sheet, and here you can change the page size. So let's consider A1, or I will just make it to A3 paper and apply on it and just close it. So now you can see this sheet is created with a A3 size, and which the A0 sheet was here, and along with this title block. So to place this or to update the title block, we have to again go to the background and and again go to the option that is frame and title block, and here we can select the resize option and just click on OK. So now you can see the A0 sheet is gone and the title block is set to the A3 sheet. So you can see the size over here, it is A3 now. So again go to the edit and go to the working views. So in this way you can start the drafting environment, you can set the initial settings as well as you can set the title block for the drafting environment sheet. So let's discuss about the important toolbars available in the drafting environment. So there are two types of tools available here. First is the direct tools and the another is the support tools. So here on the right side, all the toolbars you can see, such as views, drawing, dimensioning, then this is the annotation. So this is not the one, the annotations. These four toolbars are the direct tools, whereas the below mentioned are the geometry modify, the geometry creation toolbars, or for the interactive drafting. And the left side toolbars are the support tools, such as the text properties, style, numerical properties, update toolbar, dress up, such as adding the hatches, adding the area fields, then the graphic properties and the dimension properties. So all these are the support tools and these are the direct tools. So these are the important toolbars available in CATIA V5 drafting. So again, if you want to if you just want to restore at their original position, then you can go to the tools, go to the toolbars and just click on the restore position. So you can see all the toolbars gets restored to their original position. So thank you for watching this video. Hope you have enjoyed watching it, and do like and subscribe our YouTube channel for such more videos. So we are going to start this drafting tutorial series throughout, and will be an upcoming lecture on the next part. Thank you so much.